We are asked to factor the given expressions. For these examples, we will be using the method of substitution. For number 1, we're given x to the 4th minus 8x squared plus 15. Notice how the given expression resembles the expression x squared minus 8x plus 15, which we are more used to factoring. So what we'll do is perform a substitution so the given expression resembles this degree 2 trinomial. Before we do this though, let's write x to the 4th as x squared raised to the 2nd power. The given expression is equal to x squared raised to the 2nd power minus 8 times x squared plus 15. Remember, when we have powers raised to powers, we multiply the exponents. We still have x to the 4th here. Now, to make the given expression resemble the degree 2 trinomial that we see here, we'll perform a substitution and let u equal x squared. By letting u equal x squared, we can now write this first term as u squared, the second term as minus 8u, the third term is still plus 15. So notice how by substituting u for x squared, we now have a degree 2 trinomial, which we are more used to factoring. So now we'll factor this in terms of u. Once we do this, we'll perform substitution again and write the final result in terms of x. So u squared minus 8u plus 15 factors into two binomial factors. The terms in the first positions are u and u, because u times u is equal to u squared. The terms in the second positions are the factors of positive 15 that add to negative 8. So because negative 5 times negative 3 equals positive 15, and negative 5 plus negative 3 is equal to negative 8, one factor is u minus 5, the other factor is u minus 3. But we're not done, because remember, we're trying to factor this in terms of x, not u. So now we substitute x squared for u. So the final factored form would be the quantity x squared minus 5 times the quantity x squared minus 3. Notice how we do not have a difference of squares here or here, and therefore this is factored completely in terms of x. Let's look at our second example on the next slide. For number 2, we have 2y to the 1/2 minus 13y to the 1/4 plus 21. Looking at the fractional exponents, notice how we do not have a common denominator. Let's write 1/2 as 2/4, so the fractional exponents do have a common denominator. So the given expression is equal to 2y to the 2/4 minus 13y to the 1/4 plus 21. Notice how the given expression resembles the expression 2y squared minus 13y plus 21, which we are more used to factoring. So what we'll do is perform a substitution so the given expression resembles this degree 2 trinomial. Before we do this though, let's write y to the 2/4 as y raised to the power of 1/4 squared. So the given expression is equal to 2 times y to the 1/4 squared minus 13 y to the 1/4 plus 21. And now for our substitution, we will let u equal y raised to the power of 1/4. By doing this, notice how this first term is now 2u squared, and then we have minus 13u plus 21. Now we'll factor this in terms of u. Once we have it factored in terms of u, we'll perform another substitution to write their factored form in terms of y. Notice how for this trinomial, there are no common factors and the leading coefficient is not 1, and therefore there are several methods we can use in order to factor this trinomial. For this example, let's use factor by grouping. The first step is to determine the product of a and c, which is 2 times 21. So a times c is equal to 2 times 21, which equals 42. The next step is to find the factors of 42 that add to negative 13. Well, because negative 6 times negative 7 is equal to 42, and negative 6 plus negative 7 is equal to negative 13, these are the two factors we're looking for, and we use these two factors to write minus 13u as minus 6u minus 7u. So now we'll write this as four terms. We'll have 2u squared minus 6u minus 7u plus 21. And because we're using the factor by grouping technique, we cut this in half or group it into two parts. And now we factor the greatest common factor from the first half and the second half, and we should have a common binomial factor. The greatest common factor between these first two terms is 2u. Factor out 2u, we're left with a factor of u minus 3. Because we want a common factor of u minus 3, we'll factor negative 7 rather than positive 7 from negative 7u plus 21.
So we factor out negative 7, leaving us with u minus 3.
And notice how we do have a common binomial factor of u minus 3. So now we'll factor u minus 3 from these two products, which would give us the quantity u minus 3 times the quantity 2u minus 7. We're now not quite done though. Remember, we're trying to factor this in terms of y, not in terms of u. So now we'll substitute y to the 1/4 for u. So the final factored form is the quantity y to the 1/4 minus 3 times the quantity 2y to the 1/4 minus 7. This is the final factored form of the original expression in terms of y. I hope you found this helpful.